Over the last few days, I had numerous conversations with Frank and decided that it's time for a new voice around here. You know, sometimes my job really sucks, and this is one of the toughest things I've done because the respect that I have for Frank. And it's just, you know, I had time to think about it and watch the team throughout the year. I know a lot of you didn't expect us to make the playoffs, but obviously I have a lot higher expectations than most people of how our team should play and how far they should go in the playoffs and how they should compete every night. I just came to a conclusion that I felt that it's necessary for these guys to hear a new voice, and it's tough. Frank's not getting fired. His contract's up, and I'm just made a decision not to renew it. He'll have a lot of interest out there, and he'll be fine. But, you know, the hard part about it, and like I told Frank, is since he's been here 5.5 years and he has young children, to move his family and take the kids out of school is going to be, because I went through that. It's one of the toughest things. But in saying all that, I wish him the best of luck and thank him for everything. And now we're on the search for a new leader, a new opportunity here to move this franchise forward to a place that I think we should be. Candace?
For the new leader, what exactly are you looking for? A coach who scores?
Yeah, the same as I did when I hired Frank. You know, I brought Frank in here and with really no experience, head coaching experience, and told him what I expected. I expect guys to be professional, be out in the community, have a rapport with them, hold them accountable, you know, just get them to play hard, play together, respect one another. So the coach we bring in, I'm sure will have all the qualities to be a good leader.
Larry, in the past you've talked about how coaches get tuned out after a certain number of years.
Yeah.
Do you think this team tuned out Frank? Did he lose the locker room a little bit?
I don't know about losing the locker room. I wouldn't go that far. But just the history, been around the history of the game for a lot of years. My experience has been good coaches leave after 3 years. I played for Bill Fitch, and I've seen it happen firsthand. I talked to Red Auerbach on the subject a lot. We had Casey Jones for 5 years, nicest man I ever met, and they let him go, and we were having success. If you look at around the league, there's guys that are being dismissed, and you always wonder why. But if you're there every day and you see the things going on and you see, I don't think Frank ever lost the locker room, but I think at times players just don't listen. You know, you got to keep them mentally focused, and if you have a new voice and a new strategy, you hold your attention longer.
Larry, over here to your left.
Yes.
If somebody calls you for a reference on Frank, what will you tell them?
He's the best. I mean, he's been in our community. A lot of people know him. Great man. He's a great leader. He will do fine. And he's looking forward to the opportunity to his next job. And he's the real deal. He's a good man. Yes, sir.
Larry, when you make a hire, are you looking for a coach who will play a certain way? Are you looking for a certain style of play now?
Well, you guys know that I like to score more points than what we're scoring. This year, in offensive efficiency rating, we're about the same as we was last year. We were 23rd this year, 24th last year. We went from 27th to 12th in fast breaks, and I think that's because we got more steals and Monte was out leading the break a lot. But, yeah, I like to score more points, and hopefully we can do that. Our defense with Dan Burke's been great, like it has every year. Obviously, we can do a little bit more with high pick and rolls, probably a little bit better job. But it's all about scoring some points. But if your defense is better, you don't have to score as many. But you like to score as many as you possibly can, and you got to put the players in the right position to do that.
Is Nate McMillan a candidate?
Well, I got a list of guys. I'm just putting it together because really this decision, final decision, just came down, even though at All-Star break I started thinking about it. You know, it's really a tough deal. It really is. And so the next coach comes in, you know, I'll take my time and go through a lot and make sure we get the guy we think can lead him and keep the ears of the players and push them to higher levels than they have been here lately. We're excited about it. You know, we got I was happy for Paul coming back after his injury the way he did. And I sit out a year, so I know how tough it is. And he finished strong. And obviously with Miles, with his work ethic and his ability, I think that he's going to improve a lot. And then the other pieces, then you know, we're going to be looking around and see what we can do this summer.
Larry, you talked about the need for a new voice. And that's really all you've said about why this is happening. Is it as simple as that? Is there anything that you look at Frank and you say he didn't do well enough?
I think he did fine, you know. But it's all about motivating the players and getting them play at a higher level. And if you got their ear, it works. You know, this goes back a long time ago. I mean, I've seen it, and after a certain number of years, it's time to make a move, and that's how I feel. And I know it's not going to be a 100% popular move, but for all I think about is the franchise. You know, what's best for the franchise, and I think this is.
Larry, you talked about you have a short list of guys that you'll be looking at. Do you want someone with NBA head coaching experience? Is that important to you?
That's not important. I've seen it happen too many times. It's how they motivate, how they lead, how they get to respect the players, and obviously strategy. So that's not real important. And it's not important if they played in the league either. You know, I mean, who would know, whoever would think that Frank would have the success he had? You know, I mean, I think the best thing we did was when he came here and took over for Jimmy, he had an opportunity to win 7 or 8 out of the next 10 games. You know, it was sort of planned that way. And he did, and he got off to a good start, and I think the players bought in right away.
Larry, the feedback you got from the players in the year ends, did that play into this at all? Was there any discussion from them about wanting a change?
I don't let my players come in and talk about the coach. I never did that because that can get completely out of control. I talk to them about the season, what I expect from them throughout the summer. If they have injuries, we need to take care of them. And the things that I saw throughout the year, whether it's good or bad, I bring it up to them and talk to them about it.
Since you said you started thinking about this at All-Star break, did you ever think of making a move during the season?
No. I thought because of Frank, I felt he deserved the full year. And, you know, I don't like to make moves in the middle of the season. But he deserved the chance to finish it out.
Larry, what were your conversations with Frank like the last couple of days? How many times did you meet?
Well, we didn't really meet. We talked this morning. Probably for a half hour on the phone, he's trying to talk me out of this decision. You know, Frank loves it here. His family loves it. He kept bringing it up about, you know, can we sit down and delay the news conference and start all over again. He's going to be missed. He's a good guy. He was good for our community.
Continuity as a coaching outside of three coaches now. Frank was the fourth longest tenured coach. How do you balance continuity with getting a new ear for the locker room, especially considering only three of the guys have been here for 3 or more years?
Yeah. Well, you know, it comes down to what you're looking for going forward. I think that we got some good players, and we got two guys I think are really good players. And how are we going to get the other guys to raise their level of play? And that's what the new coach has got to do. And you know, we're looking this summer to bring in other players. We'll see what's available and what it takes to get the guys that we want. And we'll just move forward. I think the franchise is in a good position. It's just that, you know, I expect if you win 45 games, I expect us to win more this year. I think I didn't give a number before the season started, but somebody asked me the question, do you expect to be in the playoffs? And I thought he was kidding. I expect to be in the playoffs and make it through a few rounds and then see how good our players really are. Because the first round is always nice, but you don't start really get into the playoffs and know what the playoffs are about until you get to Eastern Conference Finals and the Finals. That's when the basketball really starts.
Hey, Larry, did something happen around the All-Star break? Did Frank do something, or did you see something out of the team where it made you start thinking about maybe it was time for a change?
Well, you know, our season was so up and down. You know, we win games and have some success. Then I think we lost our first three games, won. I think we're 12-5, then we lose games and we win games. We're so up and down, and I really couldn't figure it out. Was it the players weren't good enough? Was it because Paul was hitting the wall a little bit? You know, we played small early and had some success, but the whole year I was waiting on Miles Turner. A lot of people don't think summer league is valuable, but when he was down there last summer, the way he was playing and the way he was dominating, I knew right then that by All-Star break, that small ball is probably going to go out the window if we had it that long, because that kid needed to be playing. He needed to be in there getting experience. Then he breaks his hand, and I thought he was probably going to be done for the season, but through his hard work and his dedication, his love for the game, he came back and finished strong, and his future is very bright. So, but there's nothing that really I seen that other than it's just the voice, you know. I mean, it really is. It's just, you know, every day the same voice and the same. I think guys sometimes tune that out. I mean, it happens. It's unfortunate, but through my experience, Frank was here 5.5 years, and that's a long time for me for a coach.
Larry, is Kevin McHale on the list, and what's your relationship with him?
I would not do that to Kevin. Have him to work for me. That's just not fair. I respect the man too much, and we've been through too many battles together to bring him in here and be my coach. I would love for him to be my coach, but it ain't going to happen because our relationship.
Larry, if Frank had 1 year left on his contract, would he be coming back in that case? And also, how important is playing?
Well, we don't have to worry about that because he don't have 1 year on his contract.
Yeah. How important is NBA playing experience in your search for a coach?
It really, nothing. I don't buy that. Some of our best coaches we ever had in college, high school, and pro never played a game. So, you know, I don't think it's important. A lot of people do because, you know, they really get to know their players. They know how fatigued they are. They know what they're thinking. That comes into play, but it's not the most important thing to me.
Sounds like you're not in a hurry. Is there an NBA-imposed moratorium during the finals, so you either have to do it before then or after then? A and B, when do you want to have this done by?
I don't know. Just according, you know, today's when everybody will be calling for the job. And believe me, there's a lot of people out there would want this job. And I think we will take our time. I don't think it's hard to say. You know, it really is. Just interview some guys, and if you find one you really like, you just move on. But there's not a problem getting head coaches that want to come here. This is a great city, a great place to live, and we got some good talent. I think there's a lot of guys out there would love to coach Paul and Miles and some of our other guys, but we're not going to have a problem getting a coach.
Larry, you mentioned that in your conversation with Frank, he tried talking you out of this. Did he come close? Was there ever a point where you were like, well, maybe I'll reconsider?
I'd rather not talk about that.
Larry, you've mentioned that you have a number of guys on the list and that you will call them starting today. How many are on
We got to go to Chicago next week, and I'm sure I'll see a lot of them up there. I'm not going to start calling people today. You know, I've been here with Nate for 2 years, and not one time have I asked him if he ever wanted to be a head coach again. You know, it's not how I operate, and I don't ask my assistant coaches or Nate or any of them what they think the job Frank's doing, you know. Frank, I thought Nate handled himself as well as anyone I've ever seen as assistant, been a head coach to come in as assistant, but I never sit down with Nate and talk basketball strategies and different things because, you know, it's Frank's show and he works for Frank but I never did ask him if he's, you know, willing to step back into the grind.
Do you have a specific number in mind today, though, as far as the amount of candidates you want to engage
with? No. Once I get my list, I'll go after it. If the first guy is the guy I want and I like what he says and you know, the interviews are hard because they're all going to say the right things, you know, but you just have to pick their brain and see their strategies and go from there.
Larry, was there a disconnect? I know you wanted to play small and play faster, and then after X number of games, you went to the two bigs. Was that a part of your decision?
No, we, you know, Bob, what we do, me and Frank sit down every summer and strategize how we want to play. And we decided we wanted to play small. And I said this before, when the season starts, it's his game, his team. He's got to figure out how to win as many games as he possibly can, whether it's big or small. And he came to me and said, look, I feel more comfortable playing with two bigs than small. And I said, okay. And I thought that, you know, I really felt with Paul coming back from his injury, the four position would be a lot easier for him. But he said that the banging would, with the other guys every day, would take a lot out of him, and he preferred to play the three. So that was probably a part of the decision that Frank made to play two bigs. I like the small ball. I like that, you know, some nights we fired up there and make a lot of threes and beat some pretty good teams. Then other nights they fired up there and didn't make any shots and we get beat. But I think over a period of time, I think it would have worked a lot better, especially when they got familiar with each other, especially shooting a lot of threes.
Larry, yes. What do you need to do to improve the roster, or can you do to improve the roster to help the next coach?
Well, you try to get the best players you can. And, you know, we know through the grapevine there's some players would like to come here and play. We can't talk to other players right now, but, you know, there's talk out there and you hear it. But we'll see what happens. A lot of time it's just fluff. But our job is to make the team as strong as we possibly can. And the new coach might have some ideas and players that he likes. So once we get that all squared away and July comes, we'll see what's available.
Frank, or Larry, the cost of paying for a head coach in the market today has changed dramatically since Frank was hired. Is this something Herb Simon is willing to do?
Yes, we'll do what's necessary to do to get the right guy.
With a new coach coming in, whatever player moves are made, is there any reboot at all of expectations, or is this change being made because you expect this team right away to take another step up, multiple rounds of the playoffs, so on and so forth? Like,
well, I expect us to be better. I think they will be. I think when you're two better players, Paul coming off an injury, got a year on his belt, and Miles making strides like he is, instantly you should be better. Now, what are you going to add to that group, and how the other guys going to react? It's probably going to make the difference whether you move up, you know, a big leap or a small leap. But the franchise, I think, is in a good place with going forward with some of the guys we have. And you know, I always expect greatness and expect a team that's going to be competitive every night.
Larry, you'd made the decision in October not to extend Solomon Hill. What's your approach to him now?
Well, you know, like I told Solomon, the best thing that ever happened to him was us putting a boot in his butt and getting him going, because he wasn't getting the job done. And I think he'll be the first one to tell you that he was laid back. He was disappointed we didn't pick it up. But coming off of summer league, he wasn't there. He didn't play well at all. I mean, he didn't even look like an NBA player. He was out of shape. He didn't play well. And I told him, I said, you know, we might not pick up your option. So he was upset about it, and he was pouting around a little bit. But finally, I had Kevin. I said, you need Kevin Pritchard, go down and talk to him a little bit. Tell him next year I'll see him in the D League. And Kevin went and talked to him, and it fired him up. And I'm happy for the kid, because the one thing Solomon's got that you can't take away from him, he plays hard. You know, that's a talent. For a guy to come out there every day and practice and in the games and play hard, and he did. Once he got it, he started playing hard. He started getting some minutes. And I was happy for him, because I think he realized who he was as a basketball player. He's probably not going to be a 35, 40-minute guy. But he has an opportunity to get with someone and be on a team now. He played well for us down the stretch. And like I told him in the exit, you know, you never know in this league what might happen. We might bring him back. It might cost a little bit more money, but now he knows who he is as a player. That's only a plus.
Couple things. Will you talk to Paul George and some of the players about their interests or desires with a head coach moving forward?
No.
Okay.
You know, I text Paul. I wouldn't say often, every once in a while, because I don't like to bother my players. You know, when I played, I didn't want the front office bothering me. And playing for Red, he wasn't going to bother me anyway, because he didn't want my opinion on anything. But, you know, I don't let players influence me in my decisions. I will run at the end. I might run it by him, a couple of the guys. But I think it's important to get someone that they all respect, and I think that's the key.
Two follow-ups. One, did you ever meet with Frank face-to-face in the last couple of days, or has it all been on the phone?
No, it's been on the phone. We had our exit interviews. And I had something to do right after. Then yesterday he didn't come in. Then I talked to him last night. Then this morning we talked.
Okay. And last, you have this philosophy that, you know, coaches tend to not wear out their welcome, but they lose their voice in the locker room
right
after X amount of time. Do you worry that the next coach will say, well, I only got 3 years, 4 years, 5 years. It may not be a long-term situation for me in Indiana?
Maybe so. I don't think so, but you know, you don't want to get in these situations where you extend guys out after 3 years and find out it's the wrong move. Some teams do that. I tend not to do that. I don't think that'll be a problem at all. I mean, there's a lot of people want this job, and I know why. You know, it's a good place to live. We got good schools, good doctors, good hospitals, good people. We're Hoosiers, and we treat people. Other than today, we usually treat people pretty good.
Larry, this is the time of year we start hearing all kind of crazy trade rumors, both large and small. Is anything like that even on your radar right now?
No, this was a thing I was concentrating and thinking about since the season was over. So now we'll get back to business.
You ruled out Kevin McHale. Could we hit you up about Mark Jackson? That's the other day.
Well,
that's already floating.
So
what's your thoughts on him, though, as a coach?
I think he did an excellent job. I think he helped Golden State get where they're at today.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.